Hi Aries, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Aries, welcome to your 2021-22 horoscope for the year. The main theme for 2021 is the Saturn and Uranus square that is happening from February to July. That's the time when it peaks. But more so, the effect stays the entire year. We can feel the tussle, the tension, the hostility, the rebellion, the pushback that the planets are going to be giving and how it is that they're going to be affecting our lives. Now, Uranus is the awakener. He's the wild boy of astrology. He is the unconventional. Uranus rules internet. It's all about unpredictability. A lot of geniuses also are governed in their charts by Uranus as one of the major planets. And Saturn is all about restriction. It's about limitations. It's about responsibility. It's looked upon as a father planet. It's the teacher. So we have the individual voice of freedom. People wanting to express themselves against the limitations or the authority. It could be government. It can be in certain cases that you'll find that maybe there are more taxes that are being levied upon. It can be that the freedom of speech is curtailed, which I think if it is a lot of hate speech, then yes, I think rightly so, it should be done. In some cases also, we could be experiencing a lot of riots. There could be some earth events where we can expect some tsunamis, some earthquakes, and even some volcanoes. It's really a time, Aries, for you specifically, because Saturn is squaring in your house of money, and this is your earned income. So it's speaking and it's clashing with your set of values. So for you, I think the entire year is going to be, what is it that you want for yourself? Where it is that you want to go as far as your work is concerned? Where do your passions lie? What is it that you're inherently creative about? What is it that you feel really strongly about? Is it that you're so driven towards saving animals that you want to build your own animal shelter? Is it that you want to be helping people who are not as fortunate as you are? Is it that you don't want to do your 9-to-5 job and you want to start something of your own, maybe collaborate with somebody? And all of this is coming against with your ethics, your values, what it is that you think of yourself, what is it that has been instilled in you since you were very young. And why the clash? Because all of this is against things that we were taught when we were very young. Maybe our parents taught, maybe it's something that we read, maybe something that was instilled in us in the institutions that we studied. Right or wrong, their opinions and their experiences, what other people have had. And I'm not talking about history. So whether you have grown up with a thing, that it's only a 9-to-5 job that you're good enough for, there is nothing else unconventional that you can do. It could be that you may want to mentor someone, you want to be a coach. Maybe you want to paint, or you want to be a caregiver. It can be a lot of a varied of unconventional things or professions that you may want to choose, but your value system or your belief system could get challenged by this. So Uranus is going to be coming and pushing against this, and it's going to make you relook at your own sense of values, what it is that you believe in, things that you've grown up with, how far are they true, are they not true. So let me break down the year for you. We are starting on January the 6th, wherein that your ruling planet Mars, that is moving into your house of finance. So wonderful time, because Mars is going to be giving you all that momentum. It's going to be pushing you ahead. It's going to make you want to move things, to activate things, to start implementing. So if so far there have been limitations as far as money is concerned, as far as maybe an inability to sort of take an action on a certain plan has been there, and this is a time that you'll sort of just get that little boost, and you'll be running ahead, and you'll be ensuring that your plans get implemented on ground. This is also because we have Uranus in this house of your money and self-worth, with your ruling planet Mars being over there. There could be that certain decisions could take you by surprise. There could be some sort of an unexpected gain. You know, that you may not have sort of calculated it. For some of you, it could be that you hear some news about your work quite unexpectedly. It could be something that you didn't expect, and it could affect your earning capacity or your salary. From the period from February to the July, it's an extremely intense month, because this is a time where we have Uranus that is picking up, and it's squaring Saturn, and all of this is happening in cardinal and in fixed signs. So no one is willing to give way. They are like completely sort of set in their ways, and they don't want to budge. So again, the conversations or what you need to be thinking about, Aries, is the newer way of doing things, the newer way of adapting to things. Letting go of the old structures and giving way to the newer structures. The life, in any case, and society needs a good balance between the freedom and structure, you know, or without each. I mean, either the life will get too boring if it's all structure, or it will be completely wild if there is no structure with complete freedom. So for you, as far as your money is concerned, you need to be bringing in that balance. You need to be looking at your finances. You need to be looking at your career. You need to be looking at the work, things that you're passionate about. And you need to be seeing as to how it is you can become better disciplined as far as your money is concerned, how it is that you can structure it more better. There is also a lot of maybe adopting to newer digital currencies, whether there is Bitcoin, cryptocurrency that is there, maybe operating completely through digital wallet. That will may come to more application of it will happen. Maybe you're involved in a certain way. You know, banking, wherein that everything is moving on to a newer website, or maybe a more smarter, cleaner way of operating money is there. I think for you, your own personal finances really need to be, you need to be sort of be spring cleaning, or you need to be deep cleaning your finances and seeing if they're dead assets, they need to be sort of liquidated. If there is something that you need to be increasing, you need to be working on that. We have also, because your this is also your house of values, between February to July, even that gets shaken up. So your own sense of, you know, what you thought is going to stay permanent doesn't sort of stay permanent, and it shakes and it moves. So maybe you could be in a job, some of you, you know, wherein that you have thought, oh, the contract is going to get extended, or I'm going to be here for a long time, but that could get shaken, or that may have got shaken for you. On May the 15th, we have Jupiter that moves into your house of behind the scenes. This is the house of research, and we also have Neptune over here. So it's a lovely time to introspect. It's a good time for you to be planning, going inwardly, asking yourself, what is it that I really want for myself? Where it is that I, and irrespective of how old you are, where it is, what more do I want to do with my life? What is it that gives me really joy, happiness that is there? And Jupiter tends to expand everything that it touches. So you could be having just this sense of feeling very wanting to connect with your higher consciousness. Maybe you, some of you will get more spiritual during this time. Some of you could be associated with maybe shelters, animal shelters, or homes for the aged, wherein that you may want to serve For some of you, it could mean some trips to the hospital as well, and nothing serious, but it could also mean, you know, that maybe you're seeking a second opinion, maybe someone is not well in the family, and that could be taking a lot of your time. It's a good time to be speaking to a counselor as well. It's a good time to be voicing maybe deep-seated fears that you may have in your mind that you have not spoken about as yet. We have a lunar eclipse that is there on the May 29th, and that is there in your house of higher mind and consciousness and long distance travel. So May the 29th, we have something which is coming to a closure for you over here, and it's a time where you know, for maybe you are finishing a course, maybe some of you are moving from your country. For some of you, it could mean that you are seeking more spiritually. You're wanting to connect more with the higher consciousness. You want to expand your knowledge. So you could be undertaking some courses. Some of you could be signing up, could have finished signing up for some courses. You may have finished one course and you could be thinking that, okay, let me go ahead and let me do my master's in this. Let me expand my knowledge more. For some of you, it could also mean that some amount of a long distance travel, some interaction with people from different countries, cultures, ethnicities, you could be dealing with them. On the June 10th, we have a solar eclipse that is there in your house of communication, a lovely time to be communicating, networking, a great time to be expanding your network. It's a good time for you to be making newer friends, having those newer connects, expanding your network. It's also a good time to be investing some time in your neighborhood, the place where you stay, you know, your community. You could be either spending a lot of time with the people who live around you. You could be maybe bettering it. You could be involved in some kind of a committee that is there. For some of you, it may also mean that your sibling could be moving during that time, and there could be some amount of conversations going back and forth. In rare cases, I think some of you could be looking at some kind of a funding from your sibling. We have Jupiter on the 28th of July that moves back to your house of groups of friends, and this is again a time where you will be getting in touch. So July end is all about reconnecting with old friends, going back to older projects, a very nostalgic thing. Maybe some of you may have started something and then you could have thought that, okay, you know, maybe it's not, I don't have the right person to collaborate it with, and you could have left it. But this is the time that you make sort of connect with that person, and you could think, oh wow, it just falls into place, and there could be a wonderful business that you could be looking at. On the 19th of November, we have a lunar eclipse that is there again in your house of earned income. And on December 4th, we have a new moon that is there in your higher mind. So a lot of focus, I think, the entire year in any case is there in your house of earned income. There are chances of something which is coming to an end, and for you being pushed to grow, to transform. Along with the lunar and the solar eclipses that happen the entire year, and specifically for you, because they are going to be focusing on your house of finance and they're focusing on your higher mind. So they indicate maybe a time that you need to be widening your horizon. Maybe you need to be tapping into your network of friends, your groups of friends, people who are like-minded, who are your tribe, who have a similar goal that you have. And this is also a time wherein that I think a lot of you will be transforming your values. You could be changing because your belief system, maybe you've grown up thinking about a certain fear, and which is not valid, and it has just been sort of passed down generation from generation. And this is a time that you could actually be breaking patterns. The Uranus and Saturn square, it's a wonderful radical time to be breaking old habits, old patterns, things that have been deep seated in our head and we have sort of not been able to transform or change. But during this time, I think towards the end of the year, to around December, that is, that you know, you will be recognizing a lot of these patterns or these fears that you have, maybe regarding finances, regarding money, collaboration, trusting in people, trusting in your friends, wherein that you could, you know, sort of benefit from that. So all of this transformation will be taking place for you. We have the Mercury retrogrades entire, yes, we are still going to be having them, and they're going to be there in the air signs. So communication, again, I would say thinking process, whether it is written or it is spoken, that could feel slightly strained. You know, you may feel that you're not being understood, that you're struggling to sort of get your point across pretty much the entire year. And which is fine, you know, I mean, whether it's misunderstandings, I think at times as human beings, we just need to repeat ourselves in different ways to try and be understood. So along with the momentum that you have the patience and buffer in the lag time that delay Mercury retrogrades and the air signs that they are, that they may cause along with it. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Aries. I'll see you again soon. And thank you so much for watching.